This hangout on air is live. At least that's what it says. So we're going to go with it. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host, Heather. And Kraaft It Live is a live one-hour crafting show, 1 hour, give or take, crafting show where fun is to be had, mistakes are bound to happen. And you know what? You just might even learn something, too. I know I do almost every time we do this. So today we are going to be doing something really cool. I've done something similar to this before, but I had an idea, and we'll be talking about it as we go. But basically, I'm turning trash into a triptych work of art that can be hung up on the wall in series. So we're going to be checking that out. Want to say thank you to Sylvia for joining us today. I could not do this show without you, and everyone out there in the audience appreciates that you're here as well. So do you want to say hello to everybody and welcome the folks?
Okay. I want to give a big hello to Andrew. He walked into the building, so yay! Hi, Andrew. Jazzy, BJ, and her husband Abe is joining us. Beth, maybe Beth will play along because she generally does, so that's wonderful. Carol is here. Lynn's, howdy, cuz. Jules, Michael Ann, Kathleen Hartley, and Stephanie. I'm so glad you guys are joining us today.
Thank you very much.
I'm going to put up today's message, which is, you are my refuge and,
I messed it up.
You are my refuge and my shield. I have put my hope in your word. That's Psalm 119, verse 114. I love Psalms. They're my favorite book in the Bible, and I'm sure it is for many people, but I just love them.
All right. We are good to go, except that I have to move my chair.
I want to say hi to Donna. Donna just joined us too.
Hello,
hi, Donna.
Hello. Yes. Welcome to everybody. We're grateful when you're here live. If you happen to be watching on YouTube, the comments have been disabled over there, but you are welcome to join at the link in the description and come on over here and chat with us. Otherwise, watch there on your YouTube video is fine as well. I have been, let's back up just a little bit.
Okay, you know, I'll get the backup sound. Okay, go ahead.
That sounded a lot more like Norman Bates in the shower, but whatever. Okay. Okay, so I like to save things like packaging. And we've talked about this before on the Kraaft It Live show, but I like to save this packaging. And when I moved out of the house and moved into this smaller apartment, I realized I saved way more than I used. And I made myself a promise that if I was going to keep saving these things, which you know me, I was going to, that I had to use them. So I could not just save, I had to actually use them. Well, over the weekend, we had our online yard sale, and that meant that a lot of these like paper pads and whatnot, I ended up with several of them, as well as these stencil holders, packaging, etc., for papers and whatnot. And so because I had a bunch of those over the weekend with that yard sale thing, I decided I've got to figure out a way to use these. And it hit me when I got up this morning, I've got a great idea. That's what I'm going to share with you today. So what I did was I took these larger ones, like this, I measured them to see how big they were, but these work for like a 5x7 size. And these are 6x6 stencils, so they'll work for 4x6. Are you catching a theme here? They're like standard frames, you know? This is a 6.5x4.5, so that's easily cut down to a 4x6. So that's what I did. I trimmed them to 4x6 size.
Cool.
All right? So I've got, it's like stencil packaging, I think, that I did here. So we'll set these aside. Those will be a one that will do it. But anyway, today I'm going to be doing a triptych, which means three canvases, right?
Right.
And I've decided that I'm going to tape them all together and paint once rather than painting three separate pieces that can go together. I'm going to tape them all together and paint one time, and then all those pieces can go into three separate frames but look like they all belong together. So I've just got masking tape, and I'm just going to go along and tape the back side. And of course, which side is the back side? The one that you tape. That's the back side, okay? And I'm going to tape the seams, and then I'm going to tape across the seams. That'll hold it together really good for me. You could even do something like leave a gap in between, and then it would sort of skip over. That's just another thing you could do. All right. Let's see if that's too flimsy still. And I don't care about this excess stuff. I'll cut that off later. Actually, all of this will be pulled off, so it doesn't really matter if you have excess or not. But there we go. There is our canvas ready for the day.
Cool.
Now, this is stenciling package material. So it's like a cardboard or chipboard. It's sort of in between. It's thin, but it's thicker than cardstock, okay? So there's a couple of things we can do here. Obviously, we're going to gesso it because we want to add paint and whatnot, so definitely can do that. It will probably warp a little bit, which is fine with me, doesn't matter. I'm also going to be adding things like tissue paper. I've got this really cool paper that I got from a dear friend who sent me a box of goodies, and I'm going to use this Follow Your Heart as a part of it. I think this is deli paper that she
look
did
at
all
that.
Kinds of cool stuff on. Can you see that?
Yeah.
That bird stencil in there.
Wow.
Yeah, so I'm going to use that kind of stuff. But this will all help strengthen this very thin substrate, okay, as we go.
I just want to just interject here. Andrew has his techie notes, okay? I guess that's what we're going to call him when he imparts with his little tidbits of knowledge here. And he says, the backside is always the opposite of the front side. So
excellent, just, excellent.
Just need to reiterate that, you know, so in case there was any doubt,
we know now. There is no question now, that's
no question.
For sure. All right, so I've got some white gesso. That's what I'm going to start with. You can do this in any order you want to. I'm just going to start with gesso because that's what I did on the other pages or the other pieces that I already have prepared. And I got a big brush here so I can spread it out.
Is that material that you're working with shiny on that side too, Heather? Is it got like the coating on it, or is it kind of a matte?
No, not really. Not really. It's more like untreated cardboard.
Okay, because a lot of that stuff's got a shiny, you
sometimes,
know.
Yeah, sometimes. Yeah.
And that works real good if you want to make your own glue dots, you know.
That's true. That's true. Also, the cellophane that wrapped it up, too, does that. So, all right, so I want a lot of texture. So I'm using the gesso and the brush to create some texture.
Texture.
Texture, because you know how we love our texture around here.
Right, yes. Want to say hi to Mark. He just joined us.
Hi, Mark. So, as always, T-Dog is off in the wings taking pictures. I'm trying to ignore him at the moment, so I don't realize that's what he's doing, but he is. So see how it's bowing up?
Yeah.
That's fine. It'll totally flatten up as we dry it, I promise. So now at this point, if you're playing along, you can definitely get your heat tool and dry that, which is absolutely allowed. However, I have prepared one in advance.
Through the magic of the internet.
Exactamundo. And so we'll take a look at that and see all that texture in there. Ooh, as the lights get a little wonky on us. See all that texture I got going on?
Wow. Well, okay. This is interesting. Lynn says, if you're in the UK, we don't get waxed paper. So save the blanks off the sticky labels from deliveries, and they work just as well.
Oh, that's interesting. Yeah.
No waxed paper? I couldn't live without waxed paper.
Okay. All right. So the next thing that we're going to do now that this is dry is we're going to add some crackle paint.
Ooh, I like crackle paint.
I need a paper towel first, but it's very strange to have a photographer, just so you know. just giving you a little behind the scenes thoughts here.
In case anybody's wondering, because I know there's going to be some questions, Sandra won't be joining us today. She's a little bit under the weather, so.
Yeah, lots of prayers for Sandra. She's not feeling well. Okay, so this is, and it is the consistency of paint, but when it dries, it will have the crackle finish for us. So I definitely want to make sure I put some across each seam. I don't want to paint the whole thing with it. I just want to make sure that I have some here, some there. Thickness is a little bit more so here or there. I love this crackle paint. It is so fun because it goes on just like paint does. And then when it dries, you get a crackle finish that varies based on how dry, you know, how thin you put it on or how thick you put it on. And it works every single time. There has been crackle pastes that I have used over the years that have not always worked. Mm-hmm. I know some people have had difficulty with the different brands that we've even sold in the store and stuff. But this deco art seems to work for me every single time. So much so that I just recently purchased about 6 more bottles of it.
Well, that's good to know, because I know I've had some issues with particularly the Ranger, you know, products. Yeah. You know, they will, I like fine crackles, but I like really big crackles too. And you know, there was a difference. So that's good to know. Yeah.
And you'll notice that it's white, but it's a little bit different than the gesso. So you can still see where it is, where it's a little shiny. See that? And when it dries, you can use your heat tool if you want, but I have found that it's better to let it air dry, and the paint doesn't take long to dry. As a matter of fact, I had previously painted this one with both gesso and then crackle paint. I started all this about an hour before we went live. So this is about an hour ago. This was painted and it's good to go. We're ready to start.
Cool. Well, I want to just let you know that Beth Brown is going to be joining you today. She's going to be playing along, and she's using cardboard as her triptych. And she says she's feeling glass bead gel today. So
nice.
Nice.
Very nice. All right. So now that I've got one that's dry with gesso, lots of texture, as well as crackle paint that I tried showing you some of the cracks, but I'm not sure if you saw them or not.
That's a little hard. Yeah, maybe T-Dog could get a picture.
Maybe T-Dog could get a picture, but he is busy right now, so that's not going to happen.
Oh, Michael Ann's got a... And I know that that's a point, too, Michael Ann, because I've tried some crackle that does that. She says that it usually ends up on the floor, and it looks like her floor has dandruff. I've had it pop off, too. Yes.
Oh, see, now that's something I've not had happen with this deco art crackle stuff. Between all the glaze, the paint, and the paste, none of it has come off. And that's used to have that problem with some of Finnebear's. Not all, but some of hers I did have that problem with. But and if you don't seal it, it seemed like that would happen. Anyway, all right, let's move on to the next layer that I would like to add, which now you guys might not be able to see. I'm going to use this paintbrush here to show you. I've got crackle paste in this corner. That whole section there is crackle paint. This section right here, but not much. Some is here, some is up here, and some is on this corner. So the reason why I'm showing you that is because anywhere that there's not, and into where there is, I'm going to put some of this different tissue papers that I have. So this is actually pattern paper from, you know, making dresses and stuff. Let's pretend I used to sew.
I used to love to do that. Just for everybody's info, T-Dog has put some pictures up on Instagram.
Oh, thank you, Sylvia, for mentioning T-Dog's hard work. Amazing.
Oh, he's just so cute because he just does a different perspective.
Well, that's right.
Yeah, there's nothing wrong with Heather's perspective, but to see it from T-Dog's perspective, it's really cool.
I really do wish that he could hear what you're saying, because He needs to hear it from you, not from me. But
it's really cool. And I just want to just say this too, because Andrew, he's got his little techie tidbits going on here now.
Okay.
And he says, you can get the crackle effect by merely adding crushed cornflakes and spray paint.
Okay. Archival quality might not be there for that, but yes, you certainly could do that, I guess.
And if you're so brave, maybe you could eat the cornflakes after you've spray painted them.
But, wow. Okay.
Maybe you could crush them and use them as texture in something else.
Wow. I'm going to leave that there because I don't want to be held responsible if someone does it. All right, just a little bit up here.
Oh, now this is great. Jazzy said that her deco art crackle paste dried into a hard block. I added a whole bunch of water and left it for a week, and now I can mix it up.
Wow. That's incredible.
She hasn't used it, so she doesn't know if it'll still crackle or whatever, but hey, that's so cool that it can be reconstituted.
All right, just a tiny bit up here, I think. All right, now I am going over these seams, and I like that because I want, when I separate these, I want the continuity of the image. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it's going, as since I'm gluing it, it's probably going to be a little hard to deal with. We'll grab that. I don't think we will grab that. We will cross that bridge when we come to it. All right.
But that's what X-Acto knives are for.
What I was going to say. All right, so I am going to dry this. It's just matte medium. That's all I used. Very simple to glue stuff with that. Doesn't take very much, and it dries pretty quickly. Yep. All right. And then I did want to talk a little bit about...
Okay, wait before month. You go on. Okay. I have to... Yeah, Lynn, she just cracks me right up. Okay. So she says in capital letters, mind you, please tell Heather I like this as it is. She can go to the next project now. Thank you.
I swear, I love that lady. Okay. Okay, so each month we have been doing for this year a color challenge over on the Kraaft Shaak blog, and I have decided, I've made an executive decision. This is this month's colors. And I've decided that this is the last time that I'm going to actually share the colors with you guys. I'll probably still be using them myself, but I'm no longer going to be doing the Kraaft Shaak 3 Colors Challenge. It's just too much to keep up with, and not really many people have been participating. So I've got a different challenge we're going to be doing over on the Google Plus Crafters community, but that won't be announced today. So as sort of a farewell to the color challenge, I'm actually going to use the colors today. That's what I'm going to use. So, because I'm using those colors, I've got Buttermilk, the Dazzling Metallics Festive Red, and then instead of the deep, let's see, what's it called? Ultra Blue Deep is the color up there. Instead of that, I'm actually going to use a spray, the Primary Cyan. Hmm. All right. And... yeah, I think I'm ready because these are dry. Yes, they are. Okay, so first things first, I'm using my palette knife today, and I am going to be working strictly abstract. It's all about abstract today, which is fun for me because, you know, I never really do abstract very much, and it's grown on me over the couple of years now, huh?
Yes, it has. It just makes me chuckle every time.
I know, every time. Every time, it sure does. All right, look away, Linz, look away. All right, so I'm using the palette knife because I love how it scrapes across, and, you know, you get all that added texture fun. But then I'm also going to spray it with, this is just water in a spray bottle that I just filled. So of course I gotta get it started. All right. And then where did my brush go?
Linz is moaning over there, I want you to know.
I figured as much. I said look away. Did she not listen to me?
Oh my God. Everybody's saying they like this month's colors, and then Michael Ann, she says, there's a couple of month's colors I like, so I can't. That just cracks me up, because I remember that one month's color, everybody was having such a cow about them, but I loved them.
Yeah, I didn't do very well with those colors myself, but.
That's the one where I did the bruise, because it was just so perfect.
You're so funny. All right, so there's one of the colors. And I'm going to dry this because I really don't want them to blend just yet. And as I add more colors, you should see some of that crackle paste sort of pop out. Paint, crackle paint. The colors are too similar at the moment, so. And don't worry, I am going to use more of that. I just am not there yet. So if you're a member of the crafters community, then you will be experiencing some fun challenge, if you should choose to accept them, moments. We'll be talking about that over there. If you're not a member of the crafters community, I don't know where you've been, because it's a cool place to hang out. Linz has been posting over there like mad.
Oh my gosh, and her tunes are just absolutely amazing. I just love Hammy, and I love the one where in the bathing beauty in the bathing suit. Oh my gosh, that was adorable. Of course they're all adorable, but today's Hammy's with her with the horse and thing. I love, not the horse but the cow. I love Moo. It's so cute. I really expect you to put that book out soon, Linz. I'm telling you, it's golden. It's golden. Oh, pretty, pretty.
All right, let's.
Oh.
Yeah.
We have some more posts to look at, people. Oh my gosh, nice picture. Very good. T-Dog, so good.
I need to get him a director's chair with his own headset so he can hear what you're saying.
Yes, absolutely. Oh, look at that.
Oh. All right, I need my wipes here.
Linz is saying she's going to rename the community to Linz's Art Gallery if people don't post more. I like that, Linz. That's really cool. I think summertime's hard, though, because so many people are doing so many things in summertime, vacations and stuff.
Yeah, or traveling to try and make Kraaft Shaak on the go work. Or
yeah.
Okay, let's go with that for right now. Can you see the crackle appearing now? Can you see that?
Oh, yeah, hold it a little closer. Maybe we can see lines. Very pretty.
I think T is trying to take a picture here. Let's see if I can get you one. Yeah, that's good. Can I do another one?
Yeah, Michael Ann, I agree with this tune book too. My gosh, that woman's so talented. I just think she's amazing. So Linz, listen to us.
Mr. Crafter's been talking about doing that with the Kraaft It Live tunes that she shared with us. But, you know, with all the free time we have.
Yeah, right.
Oh, I like this.
I think we and some more posts, people over on Instagram. And if you don't belong to Instagram, you can, you know, or you don't have it on your mobile device, you can always bring it up on your computer, and it's just instagram.com/craftshack and see all the goodies that are out here. Oh, nice crackle, Heather. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, it looks really good, doesn't it?
Oh my gosh, yes.
The link to the Kraaft Shaak Instagram page is in the description of this video if you're watching on YouTube. And I'm sure Sylvia will be able to get the link and put it in the chat here if you are watching here in with us. I keep flipping it around because I'm not exactly sure which way is up right now. It almost looks like a bridge right here. I'm liking that. Let's see. It doesn't have to look like something, by the way. I'm having to use my teeth. typical. Okay. So this one I'm just going to go directly on. This is Festive Red. It's a metallic, so it's going to have that added metallic finish, which you know I love.
Okay, the link is in there. T-Dog's been posting some great pictures. Oh my gosh, that latest one is amazing.
You know, he's taking his photographer job pretty seriously. He talks about different shots he'd like to get.
Well, that's cool because he's pre-planning, so that does show that he is taking it seriously.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, the latest one is amazing with that crackle in it. Wow. I love crackle. In case anybody didn't know.
No, we had no clue. No clue. Oh, that's funny.
Okay, I'll let everybody know in on a secret here, okay? I love crackle.
Oh, that secret. Yeah.
Yeah, that secret.
We're all grateful that you shared. We had no idea.
Then it's time for Sylvia to be quiet. Okay.
No, that is not what I said. Okay. I've got a soft brush here. I'm going to see if I can soften some of this out a little bit. And I like the pinks and purples that are going to show up as I do this.
Yeah.
Need a little bit of water because it's getting a little too opaque. And it just paper towel.
Oh, I like that. Yeah, we're taking it back off. Linda's saying that this is looking very Orient inspired to her.
Oh, that's interesting.
Yeah. And Trisha's joined us. Hi, Trisha. And everybody's saying they love the crackle. It looks fabulous.
So I'm trying really hard not to cover up the crackle because I like it myself. There. I'm trying also to make sure I stay on screen.
Beth is saying that her first colors are going on. She's using Deco Art Sweet Mint and Peacock.
Ooh. You know, I love it when you play along, but you've got to post on either Instagram or in the community, because we got to see what you're doing. course, it's not like it's the law or anything, but if you don't, then I have nothing to play with later. So it's strictly,
it is the law. What are you talking about?
It is the law. You're right.
Yeah. Beth, post on Instagram as you're going along.
Yeah, it's strictly for, you know, personal, selfish reasons on my part, of course, but I have no other way to live if you don't share. Okay, I've got to dry this because now I feel like it's at the blended areas where I want it to be blended, but I want to keep what's there, so I'm going to dry it. This metallic takes a little while to dry, though. I really like this. I'm seeing so many layers and depth in here.
Cool. She says, "Will do, I promise." Andrew says, "Sweet mint and peacock sounds like a main course in a fancy restaurant." And Lynn's is already called dibs. Oh, that's cool. For somebody who didn't want her covering up stuff. Wow, very pretty.
So while it was drying, I went in with the palette knife. You saw that. It's kind of fun because it gets a whole new, like, gooey texture to it. I don't know if you can see that.
Gooey or dewy?
Gooey.
Oh, okay.
It has like a gooey, do you see that gooey texture right there?
Okay, yeah, because it was kind of sort of dry.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, now I also pulled out white, and I meant to grab black, but, you know, it's packed away.
Ah.
Do you have any comments you can bring up on screen while I go find it? Because it's packed for classes, and I really want the black or the white script liner.
Okay.
And add some black paint to this, so. Ooh, ooh.
Oh, is it bubbling because of the heat? Oh, I love it when it does that.
I know, me too. I don't care if it's right or wrong. I love when it does that. And a little bit more over here too. Let's see.
Okay.
So why the reason why I chose these colors? Or not these colors, these sizes, is because I knew that I could go to a very inexpensive store and buy frames and not have to worry about, you know, getting it framed at a specialty shop or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
And I think what I'm going to do after we're done here is I'm going to go to the store and get me some 4x6 frames. And then I'll take pictures to put them up for you guys so you can see just what it looks like. We won't be able to do that live here on the show, but you can check it out on any of the social medias. I'll post it there for sure.
Okay,
before I go any further, are you ready with a comment?
Yeah, I'm ready with some comments. Oh. Yes.
All right, I was waiting for you to tell me. Go ahead.
Okay, you ready? Go. Run. Okay.
Yeah, I've got to go really far away, so.
Okay, so I'm going to post this up. This is from Lynn. She says, drool writes as she's watching her create this. And then she'd called dibs. And then she said, yeah, as you're all too slow today. Nobody called dibs. And then Kim said, this is three pieces, Lynn. You can share. Lynn goes, big, huge letters. Nope.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, it's really cute.
All right. Are you ready now?
Yes, we're ready. Oh, wait a minute. I have to take that back off. Okay.
Thank you, buddy. My assistant helps me so I don't drop everything. Thank you, T-Dog.
And I want to let you know that Beth Brown did post in Instagram, and it looks beautiful. And Beth, let us know what size you're using because it looks pretty big.
Okay, so what I got was my fine liner, which is filled with white, snow white, titanium white, whatever, and some water, enough to make it liquid. And this is the fine liner. And then I have a Decor Mister Sprayer. We're going to add some black with that, but I'm not going to spray it. I'm going to add it with the applicator here.
Oh, cool. I'm going to put in Beth's Instagram link here, too.
Thank you.
For Beth. So you can see. Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Beth is using... Oh, azo gold.
What? You cut out on me.
Oh, crinacridone nickel azo gold. You know how we love that?
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Thirteen inches long, 9 inches tall. That's what Beth is using.
Wow. That's awesome. Need a little bit more here.
Boy, this is pretty.
So I've been watching, you know, in my free time, because I have so much of it these days.
Yes.
YouTube videos of abstract artists. And one thing that I've noticed with the ones that I like is that it seems to have some sort of flow across the whole thing. Mm-hmm. So that was what I knew I wanted to do with this. I knew I wanted it to sort of start and flow the opposite way, you know, across the whole piece. I'm not sure if I'm totally achieving what I wanted to do, but I love how it's evolving on its own.
Yes.
All right. I was going to add some of this red because this is Liquitex ink. I thought that would be fun because this is a metallic red. And this one is flat, so when it dries, it would be, you know, the metallic versus the flat, whatever. But I don't like the difference. This is a cooler red. This is a warmer red, and I don't like them. They compete. So I'm not going to use that. I have this cerulean blue, but it has sort of a hint of white in it, and I'm not sure why that is, if that was a bad batch or if that's normal. But I decided not to use that as I put it next to the piece. So sometimes, you know, things just evolve as they evolve, right? That's but I do have this silver. Mm-hmm. That's going to be nice, I think.
It makes good sprinkles, too.
Yeah, sure does. And I'm drawing it into the wet as well as the dry stuff here. Let's see what happens when we spray it. Oh, that silver is gorgeous. Can you see all that?
We can see the silver, but we don't see the shine to it.
Oh, T-Dog. Should get in there closer so that they can see the shimmer. There you go. Yep.
Can you just mention to him that everybody's loving the pictures he's posting?
I am to mention to you that everyone is loving the pictures you're posting.
And we love the perspective he's using on them.
I can't tell.
Oh, sorry. If you want him to know, you'll need to leave a comment because clearly that means way more.
Oh, okay.
He's looking through the comments and he's like, oh, really? I couldn't tell mom that they love it.
Oh.
Wow.
I have no idea.
Oh, it's too funny. You're so humble. It's sweet.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, the texture it's grabbing. I like working on smaller pieces too, because I think that I'll be able to put them up on the Spreesy site.
Oh.
Even in a frame. I think I could put this on the Spreesy site on a in a frame. All three frames together, you know. I meaning like, you know, being able to ship it. Have to be careful though, because this is metal and you're heating it with the heat tool.
Oh.
If I had feeling in this finger, it would be bad, just so you know. Oh my gosh, I don't know. Can you see this? Okay, here we go. Ready?
Oh, look at that. Oh.
You might want to do a video of that, buddy. Can you guys see all of that as I'm.
Yes.
See how it catches some of the light in the corner there? Wow, the depth of this one was totally unexpected. Okay, I have no idea where we're at on time, but I really only want to add just a little bit more. I think I'm going to add some stamping. I
We
have.
got, I just want to say there's one comment over on Instagram from somebody who's watching on YouTube.
Woohoo! Who's that?
Mon Chair, MONCHRI06.
Well, we are grateful that you're watching and
I
thank
guess
you for
it's
letting us know. Mona, all
Mona
right.
L, yeah.
Oh, we love Mona.
For
She's
that,
awesome.
yeah. And for commenting and letting us know where you were.
Exactly. Yeah, see, you can still participate.
Yeah. Linda's saying looks like 4th of July fireworks to her.
Yeah, this is the most fireworks I think I've seen. I like that. I think I
Yeah,
need a
that
little
is
bit more up here.
beautiful.
That contrasts really well with that silver right there. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Okay. All right, the last thing I have to add before, I can't believe we're already done. This makes me very happy.
Oh, what a great comment from Beth. This is beautiful. I'm going to put this up while you're doing what you're doing. Okay. She says, Heather, abstract artists have an excellent eye for perspective and fundamentals of drawing. This is so obvious in your piece. It's great.
Wow, Beth, thank you. That is
Yeah.
such a humbling comment.
That is
I have struggled with
beautiful.
abstract art. If you've watched us for any length of time, you know that. And this is something that I'm really wanting to grow in this area. And I feel like a little bit more confident than I have before.
And Andrew says it looks like reflections in Lake Michigan.
Wow.
And then Beth Brown says, Holy smokes, that's lovely. And Jewel says it's gorgeous.
Okay, you all get points. Thank you so much. All right.
This is cute from BJ. She says, I've been working with grandson's blobs. I see a whole scene in there, Heather. Andrew says, all my art is abstract. Even I don't understand it.
Okay, I'm calling it done. This makes me very
Oh, it's
happy right here.
beautiful. Yes, it's just gorgeous. And I'm going to go check out Beth's triptych that she's doing because she said she posted some more pictures of it.
I said I was calling it done, and then I wanted to add a little bit of black in here. All right, so let me finish this, and then I swear I'm done. Honest to goodness.
Ooh, love that Nicolazo gold.
You're teasing me. I can't go see it yet.
Okay. Wow, that pretty. I think that goes with everything.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think it does as well. All right, there we go.
Wow.
That's the piece right there.
That is stunning, Heather.
Okay, so the thing that I need to do is cut it into three pieces. Yep, I'm being instructed to hold it up again. I love how it just changes. Look at the depth that happens based on which way you look at it. Wow. That's
everybody's
so cool.
Saying I love it and wow. And
okay. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to dry this. I just looked at the time and realized we still have plenty of time. So flipping it around only because I want to be able to get to these whites. They take a little bit longer to dry because they have more dimension to them, you know? Mm-hmm. A little thicker than if I were to spread it out. So you want to know what I wrote here? Can you tell what I wrote?
It looks like one part says laugh to me, so.
All right, we'll just go with that. Whatever it says to you in your heart, that's what we'll go with. I'd love to tell you what I wrote, though.
And then for some reason, right where you're drawing right now looks like Andy to me.
Oh, okay. It's utter nonsense. That's what it is. Okay, that seems pretty done.
Wow.
Okay. Oh, so cool. All right, I'm gonna let it cool off. It's very hot. And I have my X-Acto knife. Yeah, exactly. And I wanted to turn it over, but I'm afraid I won't see where to cut.
Right.
So I'm going to cut along this line right here. All right. See it working just fine. There we go. Got to have patience with an X-Acto knife. Something else I'm working on. Patience.
I would just bend it backwards and stick the knife in and rip it down there.
It's not going to do that very well, though. My X-Acto blade is not that sharp enough to do that. To put it into three different frames, it's called a triptych. All right.
Oh, look at that.
Okay, so what I need to do is head over to the store when we're done here to get myself three frames. And then I'll be posting pictures of the finished piece. Here.
Wow.
Oh, come on. Boy, I did a good job of taping this with the masking tape, didn't I? Actually, I just need a new blade, really. That's the thing.
Look at that.
So imagine that in three different frames.
Wow.
That is awesome.
Very, very pretty. Holy cow.
Yeah, Kim, that's exactly what I was thinking. A new blade for my knife would be the answer. But you know what? I don't get new blades on purpose.
On purpose?
Yeah.
Is that like we cut ourselves with them?
Well, not on purpose. I don't cut myself on purpose, but yeah, that's what happens typically. All right. There we go, you guys.
Awesome.
I'd love to see if you play along, if you decide to do something like this. I mean, look, each piece is its own piece of abstract art. Look, that one looks like a city far off in the distance.
It does.
Wow. I like this. That was very unexpected. I'll have to link to you guys an artist that I've been watching that I really inspired by a lot of his work. I could not even tell you what the name of his YouTube channel is, but I will definitely link to it when you watch the replay. It'll be down in the description. For those of you who are watching us live, you can come back. I'll put that in the description when it's public, okay? This video is public, then it'll have that in the description. But anyway, what do you think?
That's beautiful.
All right, so that's it. From trash, where did the trash go? From my trash to treasure. And I've got two more pieces all ready to go that I can actually do something with a little bit different as well. So, and the start of this one here. I was going to put, so there's that one is the one that we started today. So see, it's still got some drawing to do. I was going to put this on there, but that doesn't go now. It's going to
No.
go on one of these other ones. So, anyway.
Boy, there's a lot of texture in that. One of the pictures that T Dog posted, it's
Oh,
like a
yeah.
side angle, and
Oh,
you
yeah.
can really see the texture, particularly if you expand it. Holy cow.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Definitely see all that going on there. Very, very fun. Very fun. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining the Kraaft It Live show. I hope that you've had fun, you've been inspired, and most of all, that you'll get out your goodies and turn your trash into some treasures, will you? Post it on social media and give me a tag, you know, put at Kraaft Shaak wherever you post it so that way I can see what you've done. I'd appreciate that. That's the way that I get to play along when I get to see what you guys are working on. So, anyway, have a very crafty day, everybody. Thank you very much, Sylvia.
Oh, thank you. And thank you, everybody. And thanks, Beth, for playing along and anybody else who's playing along.
Exactly. All right. Have a great day. Bye-bye.
Bye.